Hey friends, welcome to Knack Graphics. In this tutorial, you will learn to draw these lightning bolts in Adobe Illustrator. Before we start, turn off this Align Art to Pixel Grid button and make sure that smart guides are on. All right, now we're good to go. Pick rectangle tool and draw an artboard sized rectangle. Remove its stroke. And to set its fill color, open the gradient panel. Click here to apply this preset black and white gradient. Now double click this slider and set this grayscale value to 70%. Alright, this rectangle is under selection right now. Copy it and paste it in front. Copy in front is under selection right now. Set the gradient type to radial. Double click this slider. Open HSP options. Here enter 315 for hue, 90 for saturation, and 50 for brightness. Now double click this slider. HSP options. Here 240 for hue, 80 for saturation, and 20 for brightness. Now click anywhere on this bar to add a new color. Double click it and enter 240 for hue, 85 for saturation, and 20 for brightness. Set its location at 62.6%. Alright. Now pick the gradient tool. Zoom out to get a better view and adjust this gradient like this. Pick selection tool, resume the artboard to its previous size and change the blending mode of the shape to overlay. Perfect. Now lock both of these rectangles so that we may start with our main lightning bolts. Now get the pencil tool activated. Double click it to get these options. Here set this fidelity option to accurate. And make sure that this keep selected button is on. Now, starting from almost here, draw a path like this. Change its stroke color to white. Set the stroke weight to 5 points. Now, change this variable width profile of stroke to width profile 4. Now, keeping this path selected, come to effect menu. Distort and transform, hair roughen, enter 6% for size, select absolute here, enter 3 for detail, set this points option to smooth and press OK. This path is still under selection, come again to effect menu, distort and transform, select tweak this time. Here enter 6% for horizontal value, 5% for vertical. Select absolute here. Now make sure that only this in control points is checked here and press OK. Alright, here our main lightning strike has got ready. Keeping it selected, open graphic styles panel. In case you don't have this panel docked here, you can get it here in window menu. Now click here to add a new graphic style. This is the newly created graphic style. Double click it and name it First Strike. Now we'll add a couple of strikes to this main lightning strike. Pencil tool is active. Zoom in a bit and randomly draw some strikes like this. Now get both of these strikes selected and come to this graphic style panel. Click this main strike graphic style. Now to make it more realistic, you can change the stroke weight. Like I'm gonna change this one to 4 points. And I'll change this one to 3 points. Okay, These main strikes are ready now. Let's add some glow to them to make them look fierce. Select all of them and first make them a group. Name it first strikes. Now, keeping this group selected, open effect menu, stylize, pick this outer glow. Here, set the mode to normal. Double click this color picker box to set the color of the glow. Here, enter 299 for hue, 79 for saturation, and 89 for brightness. Set this opacity to 100% and change this blur value to 4 pixels. Nice. We are done with these strikes here. So I'm gonna lock this group for now. Done. Now let's add some offshoots to these strikes. Pick pencil tool and start adding fork-like split-ended paths to these strikes. Like this. Like this. Add a few more. I think these much are sufficient. Yeah. Now select all of them and change the stroke profile to this width profile 4. Keep the stroke weight at 1 point. Open effect menu, distort and transform, pick roughen, enter 4 for size, make it absolute, put 6 here and set the points to be smooth. Good. These paths are still under selection. Open effect menu, distort and transform, go for tweak this time. Here enter 6 pixels for horizontal, 10 for vertical, select absolute here. This time make sure that this out control points option is ticked here and press OK. All these paths are under selection right now. Let's make them a group. Copy this group. Paste it in back. Now copy in back is selected. Change its stroke weight to 3 points. And pick this blue color for its stroke. Open effect menu now. Here, blur, pick Gaussian blur, set this radius to 8. Now come to layers panel, unlock this first strikes group, select all these parts and make them a group. Now resume the artboard to its previous size, pick rotate tool and with alt key pressed, click on this anchor point to make it the reference point. Enter minus 90 degrees here. Press copy. Now select this group. Pick reflect tool. Click here with alt key pressed. Select vertical and press copy. Now come to layers panel and lock all these groups. Now let's add some glowing spots to these lightning bolts. Pick ellipse tool. Click anywhere to draw an ellipse. Enter 75 for both width and height. Remove its stroke. For its fill, come to gradient panel. Select this black and white gradient. I want radial gradient. Nice. Now double click this color slider. Get grayscale color value. Enter 30% here. Now click this black color slider and reduce its opacity to 0%. And now change the blending mode of this shape to color dodge. Now place it here. Let's place a few more copies of this shape. Simple trick, drag out the copies by pressing Alt key while dragging. Adjust them if you feel like. You may change their count too. Now to add on, pick pick flare tool, click here, set this diameter at 164 points, opacity at 50%, bring this brightness option to 0, enter 50% for this halo growth and keep its fuzziness at 50%, set this raise count to 50, enter 50% here and keep the fuzziness at 100%. I don't want these rings, so just check them out. Great, this is exactly as I want it to be. So our lightning bolt design with some add-on effects is ready here. Share your feedback in the comment section and stay connected for upcoming tutorials. Goodbye for now.